SpaceX is heading back to the ISS on its 18th resupply mission for NASA. This mission is packed with science experiments from bioprinting organs to researching the effects of microgravity on the human body to soccer balls and even slime. Yep, that's right, Nickelodeon is studying slime in space. All these sent up with the hopes of expanding our knowledge of life and microgravity. As part of that goal, Expedition 60 crew member Andrew Morgan will be the latest NASA astronaut to join the ISS crew. It'll be his first mission to space, and he's been given the rare opportunity to stay on board for a much longer period than his peers. Usually, astronauts stay on board the ISS for about 6 months, but for Morgan, he'll be staying for 9 to conduct groundbreaking microgravity research on the human body that will continue where Scott and Mark Kelly's twin study left off.
Well, certainly I'm very interested in those experiments that have a medical bent to them because we want to study and understand how the human body changes over long periods of time in microgravity.
And he won't be alone in this mission, as fellow NASA astronaut Christina Cook has been selected to stay in space just shy of Scott's 340-day record. Over the duration of her stay, Cook will be the subject of a study that will demonstrate the effects of long-term spaceflight on the female body for the very first time. We'll be diving into this in an upcoming episode, so stay tuned. In total, the ISS crew will be busy working on around 250 experiments, including the first US bioprinter to be sent to the station by TechShot. Their system is called the Biofabrication Facility, or BFF, an experiment aiming to one day print organ-like tissues in space. Bioprinting soft tissues on Earth can be a challenge, as tissues can collapse under their own weight. So printing in microgravity becomes a huge advantage as it removes the need for scaffolds that usually hold difficult structures. The BFF works by printing the tissue cells inside cassettes, which are then placed into an incubator system using TechShot's Advanced Space Experimenter Processor. After up to 45 days of maturation, the tissue will retain its shape upon its return to Earth. And they're aiming for the stars to try to achieve something that's never been done before in the field of 3D bioprinting.
So that's our first thing that we're gonna try to do, is create something that has a blood vessel component to it, muscularized tissue that's a centimeter thick.
These advances in 3D bioprinting present a huge opportunity for personalized medicine. By using a patient's own cells to print an organ, their bodies would have an easier time accepting the new organ and would remove the need for anti-rejection drugs. And seeing this project near usability is a dream come true for Eugene.
I still get goosebumps. You know, this was one of those like, you know, crazy backroom conversations that are like, hey, you know, wouldn't it be cool if, but this one, you know, right time, right place, right people, right team. And all of a sudden, you know, we're, you know, T-minus 3 weeks from, watching a really big candle get lit down in Florida.
Eugene isn't the only researcher who's got a lot riding on this mission. The US ISS National Lab is sending 25 scientific projects, an all-time high for a resupply mission, of which 17 are private sector projects sponsored by the lab. Goodyear is sending materials in order to test the production of new silica forms and structures in space that could help inform future evaluations of manufacturing tires on the ground. Adidas is including its soccer balls to study how a spherical, free-flying object rotates in space that could help inform how free-flying objects interact with their environment. And then there's Nickelodeon, who will be filming how slime acts in microgravity in an effort to teach its young viewers about the basics of fluid dynamics. And there's one pretty big element left on this mission. Sitting in the trunk of the Dragon cargo is an International Docking Adapter, or IDA. Built by Boeing, the IDA-3 converts the older APAS to the NASA docking system, allowing newer spacecraft like the Starliner and Crew Dragon to autonomously connect with the space station for the first time, using lasers and sensors to digitally communicate distance cues, alignment guides, and final connection. The docking system has also been designed to welcome spacecraft yet to be designed from any space agency in the world.
I think it'll enhance our cooperation because we fully intend to continue to fly astronauts and cosmonauts from different communities on either vehicle. And also just another real honor for us to be up there potentially when these vehicles visit for the first time.
And hopefully that historic moment will come soon. So while we wait for the arrival of SpaceX's Crew Dragon and Boeing's Starliner, we can look forward to the incredible science happening above and continuing to explore the endless boundaries of space. Are there any experiments you'd like us to cover more in depth? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and keep coming back to Seeker. Thanks for watching.